ask you to write about which explanation for intertext these three texts, the poem, the novel, and the short story, you think is the most valid. So let me throw a few of these ideas at you. You think them over, do a little bit of writing, use evidence from the texts, and let's see what we can come up with. Okay, so the first one is this. Basically, that even though every veteran's experience is unique, published war stories are full of cliches that authors use as shorthand to evoke emotions in their non-veteran readers. This approach kind of looks at the idea that it's this very like romantic idea that you know every person is an individual and is going to have their own individual experiences, and those of us who have not had those experiences need to have them conveyed to us in sort of a cliched manner. Okay, so you think about, you know, who's the audience for these texts by veterans, or most of the people who are reading them are not veterans themselves and had no experiences that are even similar to what's being presented there. So they have to be oversimplified. And that would explain why The Man He Killed, Chapter 9 of All Quiet, and The Man I Killed are so similar in so many different ways. The next explanation is looking more at human psychology and the idea that because humans naturally abhor killing when it is personalized, you know, in other words, close quarter killing, more so than distance killing. You think about Paul with the French guy in the crater, you know, Paul killing that guy in hand-to-hand combat versus the sniper at the end of that chapter. So because humans naturally abhor killing when it's personalized, similarities between The Man He Killed, All Quiet on the Western Front, and The Man I Killed illustrate a fundamental truth about how people think about war. Again, this is a more psychological explanation. This is one that was put forth by the modernists. There are obvious counterpoints to this. You think about, you know, like a revenge culture or something, you know, like the Spartans or something like that, and you say that's them, not us. And you know, maybe psychology is different for people in different cultures, but these are all things that you can think about on your own. The last one, it's actually two very similar ones, but the idea that the author's experience reading earlier war narratives was at least as important to the writing of the text as, you know, the author's combat experience. So Remarque's experience reading earlier war stories, The Man He Killed, probably The Red Badge of Courage by Stephen Crane, some of you guys have read that, you know, maybe the Iliad, like all these different war stories that get into questions of killing at close range. You know, because he had ingested all of those texts, those actually were more important to him when he was writing his own story than his actual combat experience was. Likewise, O'Brien, you can add in, like, you know, All Quiet on the Western Front is something that Tim O'Brien definitely read while he was working on, you know, The Man I Killed, or maybe he read All Quiet on the Western Front before he went off to war. He actually, the real life Tim O'Brien, was drafted into the Vietnam War after he graduated from college. He probably read All Quiet on the Western Front in high school, just like you guys are. So, you know, that was probably in his head. The postmodernists would have you believe that while Tim O'Brien was actually fighting in Vietnam, he was thinking subconsciously about All Quiet on the Western Front and all these other books he had read. So that's another thing to think about. So I'm asking you again to think about which one of these theses is most valid, this romantic one. The evidence, it's just evidence of cliches and war stories. The modernist one, that it's just psych, you know, human nature or psychology to feel this way, or the postmodernist one, that these writers with combat experience are actually also way more influenced by books they had read and other texts they had read than their actual combat experience. So take a few minutes, do some thinking and writing about this, use evidence from all three texts, and I'm really excited to read.